Gaurav, and I'm here to teach you the subject physics. And our today's topic is, obviously it is written on the board, electricity. This is the first chapter of class 10th, and the board obviously is CBSE. Right, your prescribed book is Aschan. So in Aschan, there is a first chapter is electricity. Basically in class 10th, in subject physics, there are basically three units. First is a light unit, that is optics. In light, there is a reflection of light, and second chapter is refraction of light, and third is human eye and its colorful world. And the second unit is electricity. In electricity, we will cover electricity, that is heating effect of electricity, and the second one is the magnetic effect of electric current. And the third one is sources of energy. So this is the total syllabus of class 10th. This is very compact and very easy syllabus, right? So our first unit is electricity, and this is our first session. In first session, we will cover some topics as I have already written on this board, you can see. Right, in our first session we will cover the topics like electric charge, conductors and insulators, electric potential and potential difference, electric current and direction of electric current. And one more important thing I will share with you, that I will record this whole video, this entire session, in the form of a snippet, and this is very beneficial for all the students, because in the snippet form you can directly go to the another topic. For example, if you know what is electric charge, what are conductors and insulators, then you need not to view this particular thing, right? If you know about the electric charge, conductor, then you directly go to the electric potential and potential difference. If you know about this topic, you will directly go to the electric current, the explanation of electric current. So I will explain this much, and if you skip this part and you directly want to go to the explanation of electric potential and potential difference, then you will do it. Saves your time, right? So our first topic is electric charge. So what is electric charge? If someone asks what is electric charge, what will you answer? Right, you will answer that electric charge is the basic physical property of matter that causes it to experience a force when placed in electromagnetic field. I again repeat, electric charge is the physical property of matter that causes it to experience a force when placed in electromagnetic field, that is written inside EMF, right? Electromagnetic field. So electric charge is a physical property of matter that causes it to experience a force when placed in electromagnetic field. Actually, electric charge is the basic property of matter that carries some electric charge. You know, matter is made up of, composed of atoms, and atoms are further composed of three elementary particles, that are electron, proton and neutron. So electric charge is the basic property of matter, right, which is carried by electric charge which is carried by some fundamental particles, elementary particles or subatomic particles. All the names are same, right? They will indicate only one term, right? You can say fundamental, elementary and subatomic particles. So these particles of matter carries electric charge. For example, electrons are negatively charged, while protons are positively charged and neutrons are neither positive nor negative. That is, it is neutral. That's why we will call it neutron. So neutron is neutral charge. It has zero charge. So in general, there are two types of charges in nature, that are positive charge and negative charge. Right. If we say, or for example, if we have two bodies, body A and body B. If we have two bodies that have an excess of one type of electron, that is one type of charge, right? So for example, body A is positively charged and body B is positively charged. If body A is negatively charged, then body B is also negatively charged. So if we have two bodies have an excess of one type of charge, then they will exert a force. Which type of force exists there? Obviously, the force of repulsion. Then they will exert a force of repulsion. They repel each other when they are relatively close together. When they are get close together, they exert a force of repulsion. When both type of body have an excess of, have the same type of charge, right? That is positive positive and negative negative. In another scenario, if these two bodies have an excess of opposite charges, like this one has positive charge and another body is negatively charged, then they will exert a force of what? Then they will exert a force of attraction. Then they, when they relatively nearer, they will attract each other. There is a force of attraction. So we can say that, first thing is, like charges, or we can say similar charges, repels each other. For example, positive repels positive charge, negative charge repels negative charge. And the second thing which we observe, that unlike charges or dissimilar charge, opposite charge attracts each other. For example, positive attracts negative and negative approaches to or attracts towards positive, right? Negative attracts positive, positive attracts negative. Both things are same, don't worry, right? Unlike charges attract each other. And one thing we should know here, that how we denote electric charge. We will denote electric charge by the capital letter Q. Electric charge is denoted by capital letter Q or small letter Q. You can denote electric charge either capital Q or small Q. Okay. And what is the SI unit of electric charge? SI unit of electric charge is COULOMB, and SI unit is denoted by capital letter C, not small letter, it is denoted by capital letter C, and this is the name of the scientist. So the unit of charge is based on the name of scientist, or it is given the name, and this name is given in the honor of our physicist or scientist, right? Okay. Another type of unit, we will also express the unit of charge like Q is equals to IT, that is ampere second. Ampere second is also the unit of charge, right? You should know that Coulomb is electric charge is not the fundamental physical quantity. It is not the fundamental physical quantity, right? It is not the fundamental quantity. It depends on the electric current, right? We can consider charge fundamental quantity, but we couldn't. We accept accept charge. We will consider electric current as a fundamental quantity. There is a historic approach. There is a historical background behind it, and some more problem with electric charge, right? To define electric charge, it is very difficult to define electric charge, right? Okay, skip that part. I am not going to explain everything here, right? Okay. So ampere second is also the unit of electric charge, right? Okay. There is a formula, you know that Q is equals to plus N minus ME. So Q, what is capital Q? Q is the charge on a body, or N is the number of electrons, and E is the charge on an electron. And you should know charge on an electron is 1.6, a modulus of charge, right? Charge on electron, magnitude of charge. We will not discuss here the nature of charge. Obviously, we include the nature of the charge, then we have to place minus here. If the charge of one proton is similar to, is similar as charge of one electron, right? So charge on magnitude of charge of an electron is equals to 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb, right? If we also include the nature of charge, we will place negative here. If someone says what is the charge of one proton, it is plus 1.6 into 10 power minus 19, right? Okay, this is the magnitude, right? So if we know that if a body has deficiency of some electrons, then the body is said to be positively charged. In another body, if there is a excess of electron, then the body is said to be negatively charged. So if we want to express the charge on a body, is denoted by capital Q, and there is a deficiency of an electron. So what is the magnitude of the charge? What is the charge on a body? Because there is a deficiency of n number of electrons. Here the deficiency of electron, for example, we can say 1 electron, 2, 3, 4. There is a deficiency of 4 electrons, so the charge on a body is, n is 4 here, so the charge on a body is 4e, where e is the 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 coulomb. and we know if there is a deficiency on a body, then the body is positively charged. So we place here, nature of the charge on a body is positive, positively charged. Charge on body B, so Q subscript B, charge on body A, this much, and charge on body B. There is an excess of 4 electrons, so the charge on a body is 4E. There is an excess of electron on body B, so what is the nature of the charge on a body, charge carried by that body is negative, right? Similarly, if there is a n number of electrons, there is excess of n number, sorry, if there is a deficiency of n number of electrons, if there is a excess of n number of electrons, then we wholly say that the charge on a body is expressed as Ne plus minus. If there is a excess of electrons, then we place minus, then we know that the charge is minus Ne. If there is a deficiency of electrons, then we know the charge on a body is plus Ne. So wholly we can say charge on a body is plus minus Ne. And we know that one thing I should remind you, that a body has electron, a body has excess or deficiency of electrons in the integral terms, right? A body has charge on it in the multiples of E, integral multiples of E. That is, body has a charge of 1E, 2E, 3E, 4E, but a body has never charge on it like 2 by 3, because 2 by 3 is not integer, it is not integral multiple of E. So 2 by 3 is not a charge carried by anybody. There is a not charge of 1.5E, right? So a body in nature, in the world, a body has only charge a multiple of E, right? So this is all about the charge, right? This is all about the charge. We are not going in depth of all these things. This is upar, right? This is the overview of the electric charge. So we will cover here electric charge. This much is going to be your syllabus, right?
So our next topic is conductors and insulators. As we completed this particular term, electric charge, now it's time to read about conductor and insulator. As you know, this is very basic term, conductors and insulators. You had already read about it in your previous classes. So conductors and insulators are very easy topic for you. Okay. As you know, in some materials, in some substances, electric charge can flow easily, while in some materials it cannot. So on this basis, we can divide substances chiefly or mainly into two electrical categories, that are conductors and insulators. There, in your upcoming classes, in your higher classes, you will learn one more electrical category, that's name is semiconductor, whose conductivity is between conductors and insulators. Semiconductor is not in your syllabus, so we can skip that thing. So conductors and insulators, we will only talk about conductors and insulators. As you know, the definition of conductors, what are the conductors? Those substances are called conductors through which electricity can flow. Or simply you can say, those substances through which electricity can flow are called conductors. For example, copper, aluminium, silver, gold are called conductors. Actually, all pure metals are conductors, because metals has free we will talk about it later. Right? So basically all metals are conductors. Some metal alloys are also conductors, like manganese, nichrome, and constantan are also conductors, but their conductivity is much, much less than pure metals. Actually, these metal alloys are used in some electrical element. Some electrical appliances as a heating element, because their conductivity is very low. Their conductivity is very low. That is much less than the pure metal. So their resistance is very high. So if resistance is high, then if you pass electric current through it, then they will generate heat. So as a heating element, we use metal alloys, right? So now we talk about insulators. What are insulators? Just simple definition. Insulators are also known as poor conductors, right? You can say poor conductor. Insulators are defined as those substances through which electricity cannot pass, are called insulators, right? So simply you can say those substances through which electricity cannot flow are called insulators. For example, wood. For example, wood, paper, rubber, mica, cotton, right? All things are insulators because they cannot pass electricity through them. Okay. One more thing is that, I would say wood. I would say dry wood instead of wood, because in nature we acquire wood which has some percent of water in it. So when we write the example of insulator, we should add a word before wood, that is dry. We should write dry, not wood. Okay. So what is the basic thing, what is the major factor that a substance is conductor or insulator? The main factor is that presence of free electrons. Those substances in which free electrons are available, they can flow through the they can flow through that material. If they can flow through that material, then that material would be a conductor, right? So all metals are conductors because they have electrons. There are much theories and there are much things, right? But in our point, in our syllabus, only conductors and definition of conductors and insulators and their examples, right? We will only cover that much. Okay.
Now our next topic is electric potential and potential difference. We covered in this first session electric charge, conductors and insulators. Now it is turn to explain electric potential and potential difference. And this particular term have important place through all this chapter. In the entire chapter, this is a frequently used term, right? So this is very important. Pay attention on it. Okay. I have already written electric potential and potential difference. Potential difference has another name also, that is named voltage. The unit of electric potential is volt. So volt gives rise another name, voltage. Potential difference has another name, voltage. Voltage and potential difference both are the same thing, right? So to save your time, I have already written all these things and my also. It saves my time also. Okay. So what is electric potential? Okay. I'm not going to explain each and everything here. I will cover only the basic definition of this term, right? In my earlier videos, in my earlier videos, I have explained all this thing in very depth manner. So to know about these terms, you can go and watch that video, right? So the electric potential at a point in an electric field is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge from infinity to that point. So to know the electric potential at a point, we have to bring a positive unit charge, a positive 1 coulomb charge from infinity to that point. And in bringing that test charge from infinity to that particular point, what we have to do? We have to do work, right? We have to do work. Either agent have to work or the system have to work, right? Okay, let me explain here, right? There is a charge Q. This is, that charge is fixed charge, and there is a unit positive charge, that is plus 1 coulomb. Unit means 1 coulomb charge, positive charge any plus 1 coulomb charge. So the work, if you want to know the potential at this point, right, we want to know the potential at point A. So VA is defined as the work done in moving, let's say we have to work W from infinity to point A. If we bring plus 1 coulomb, a unit positive charge from infinity to point A, we have to work W. So electric potential at point A defined as VA is equals to W by Q. VA is equals to W by Q. So simply the definition is the electric potential at a point, the electric potential at a point in an electric field is defined as the work done, is defined as the work done in moving a unit positive charge, in moving a unit positive charge from where? Infinity to that point. So this is just a simple definition. Please read that definition and learn. Electric potential at a point in electric field as the work done in moving a positive unit charge from infinity to that point. Right, the electric potential is denoted by capital letter V. It is denoted by capital letter V. And the SI unit of electric potential is volt. V is equals to W by Q, and the SI unit of W is joule, and SI unit of charge is coulomb. So the unit of electric potential is joule per coulomb, and its unit is also volt, which is given to honor the physicist named Alessandro Volta. So its unit is volt also, right? Now moving to the next thing is potential difference. What is potential difference? What is electric potential difference? We will only talk about electric potential difference as we read chapter electricity, not gravitational potential difference, right? So if we not write here electric potential difference, you know this is electric potential difference, right? Right. Okay. What is electric potential difference? So as the term is already suggest us that this is a difference in electric potential between the two points. So that, what is the basic definition? The definition is the potential difference between the two points in an electric circuit is defined as the amount of work done in moving a unit charge from one point to other point, right? The potential difference between two points in an electric circuit is defined as the amount of work done in moving a unit charge from one point to other. Let's say through example I can explain it. Example, right? Okay, in an electric circuit there is a two point A and B, right? In electric circuit, consider it is an electric circuit, right? I'm not going to draw full circuit here, right? In an electric circuit there is a two point A and B. There is a potential at A, there is a potential at B, right? If W joule, if W joule work has to be done in bringing a charge Q from point A to point B, then the potential difference between the points A and B is given by VAB is equals to W upon Q, right? So this is simple, okay? So we can know the potential at point A, VA, VB, and the difference of V and VB is VAB, right? So this is the potential difference, right? If you want to know VA, bring a charge from infinity to that point and divide that charge to work done. If you want to know the electric potential at point B, bring the charge from infinity and applying this formula, you can know the VB. Now make a difference between them, then you will get potential difference, right? I will, okay, let's skip that. Okay, this is the electric potential difference. Now, electric potential is also known as voltage. I have earlier told you, okay? Next thing is, potential difference is measured by a means of instrument called voltmeter. Potential difference is measured by an instrument called voltmeter. And two things you should know about voltmeter. A voltmeter has high resistance. Voltmeter has high resistance. Why it has high resistance? So that it takes negligible current from electric circuit, right? Okay. And the next thing is, voltmeter is always connected parallel across the points. Where we have to measure potential difference, right? To get it better, I will draw a simple circuit. So if there is a resistor of resistance R between the point A and B, if you want to know what is the potential drop, yeah, what is the voltage across this resistor, we have an instrument named voltmeter, and the symbol of voltmeter is like this, right? So we connect voltmeter parallelly across these points A and B. Okay, this is positive terminal, this is negative terminal, so electric current will flow in this direction, positive to negative. If voltmeter has high resistance, then no current will flow through voltmeter, right? So a voltmeter has high resistance. If voltmeter has a low resistance, then current will divide between resistance R and voltmeter. So voltmeter takes some electric current, that is some electric energy, then the potential drop is not accurate, then we do not get correct potential difference between point A and B. That's why we have voltmeter as high resistance. Or you can simply relate it with Ohm's law, V is equals to IR. If resistance is high, then potential drop is very low. Or right? So if voltmeter has high resistance, if it has high resistance, then no current will flow through this. Or I is equals to V by R, right? If R is very high, if R is goes to infinity, and you know that no matter has high resistance. Even insulator has some conductivity, right? No one has high resistance. No one has infinity resistance, right? But for the sake of time, you can consider if R is goes to the infinity, then what is the current in that circuit? If R is going to infinity, when we divide a thing with very big number, then the number goes to the zero. So I is equals to zero, 0 ampere. So if voltmeter has high resistance, then it takes zero current, right? That's why we have voltmeter has high resistance, right? So this is the electric potential, about electric potential and potential difference, right? Okay. Now the next topic is electric current. So without wasting your time, what is electric current? It is just simple. It is the rate of flow of electric charge. Or you can simply say that the quantity of electric charge flowing through cross section of a given conductor in 1 second is called electric current. The quantity of electric charge flowing through a cross section of a conductor, flowing through a cross section of a given conductor in 1 second in unit time is called electric current. If electron is flowing in this direction, then what will be the polarity of the cell or battery, right? This is positive and this is negative. Current will flow in this direction and electron flow in the opposite direction. So what is electric current? The quantity of electric charge flowing through cross section of a given conductor in 1 second is called electric current, right? If q coulomb of charge is flowing through a conductor in time t, then the current is given by I, which is equals to q by t. Because we want to know what is the electric charges, what are the electric charge flux, or what is the electric charge will move through conductor in 1 second. So the electric charge q will move in t second, then in 1 second the charge flow q by t. So and q by t is equals to I, right? So basically I is equals to q by t. What is the unit of electric current? Unit of electric current is, what is the SI unit of charge? That is coulomb, and the SI unit of time is second. So coulomb per second is the SI unit of current, and coulomb per second is also known as, or the another unit of electric current is ampere, right? Actually the SI unit of current is ampere. Ampere is nothing but coulomb per second. It is given to honor the our scientist ampere, right? The name of scientist, the name of physicist is ampere. So upon that name, it is given as ampere, right? Okay, I is equals to q by t, and as a unit of electric current is ampere. Now, what is the physical quantity? What is the physical quantity? Electric current is which type of quantity? It is scalar quantity. It is not a vector quantity. It is scalar quantity. So electric current is defined only by its magnitude. We can define the current by 2 ampere, 3 ampere. The current flowing in the circuit is 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 1.5 ampere, 0.25 ampere. It does not have direction. To define electric current, there is no need to define the direction, right? Okay. Now the next point is, how to measure electric current in a circuit? The measurement of electric current flowing in a electric circuit is given is by means of an instrument called a meter. A meter is an instrument by which we can measure the electric current flowing through a circuit. And two things about a meter you should know. A meter is always connected in series. A meter is always connected in series in the circuit in which we want to know the electric current, right? Let me draw a simple circuit diagram. Right, plus minus. So the polarity of ammeter is also plus minus, right? We want to know what amount of electric current is flowing in the circuit. We will connect ammeter in series with circuit, right? If this is the resistor of resistance R, these simple straight lines are connecting wire, and connecting wire has negligible resistance. So there is no drop of voltage, there is no drop of electric, there is no need to work of electrons to move through connecting wire. But when electron go through resistor, then because it has some resistance, so electron has to work, right? They get restricted here, right? Okay, not going in depth. Simply, to know the electric current, we will connect ammeter in series with that, right? Series means end to end connection, right? And the second thing is, ammeter has very low resistance. Ammeter has very low resistance. An ammeter has very low resistance. Why it has low resistance? Because, or so that it may not change actual or accurate current flowing through the circuit. If it has low resistance, means it has approx zero resistance, then by the formula V is equals to IR, so V is equals to I into R is equals to zero, then V is equals to zero. So when charges move through the ammeter, then there is zero potential drop, there is no drop, there is zero drop, right? So when there is no drop in potential difference of voltage, then it may not change the actual current flowing through the circuit. Okay. Now our next topic is direction of electric current. So this is already told you in my previous videos. So direction of electric current, what is how we know the direction of electric current? So by conventions, the direction of electric current is from positive terminal of the cell to the negative terminal of the cell. Let Let me draw a simple circuit for you. There is a bulb, right? So this is the cell. A cell has two terminals, positive and negative terminal. This is a cell, okay, positive and negative. There is a cell having positive and negative terminal. Actually, they have, okay, the positive and negative terminal, and the electricity can electricity flow from higher potential to lower potential, and by convention, positive terminal has high potential and negative terminal has low potential. So electricity flow from positive to negative direction, while electrons flow from negative terminals to positive terminal, that is from lower potential to higher potential. The direction of electron is just opposite to the direction of current. Actually, the charge which is flowing through the circuit is electron, right? So the electric current is due to the flow of electrons in the circuit, right? So, or we can say that the direction of electric current in the circuit is opposite to the direction of electron, right? Okay, so this is all about the direction of electric current. This is enough for you. Okay, so this is all about our first session. We cover from in this session electric charge, conductors and insulators, electric potential difference, electric current, and lastly direction of electric current. So thank you so much.